a real honor to be a nominee of the Utah Leopold Conservation Award 2019. Our farming and ranching operation is located in Alton, Utah. It's halfway between Panguitch and Kanab, Utah. And it's a ranching operation in which we raise cattle. We run our cattle on our summer range, which is in Alton, Utah. We have 2,300 acres in the canyons up there, private ground that we own and run them on. And we run them on this summer range until November. Then we take them on our winter range, which is in Arizona. And they stay on our winter range until the end of May. And then we bring them back to Alton and start all over again.
It's been a real pleasure to be able to work with these conservation ideas and things. We put in a 15-mile pipeline down in Arizona on our winter range, and it's really benefited several different livestock owners down there, and that's been a big plus. It makes it so that our livestock can scatter out more and get more water, and especially this year where we don't have any water down there, it's going to be a big plus having that pipeline in. The NRCS works with us in the spring of the year, in May, and we do a lot of spraying up and down these washes and on our private ground, also on the BLM ground to try to control the Scotch thistle. And my son and I built this fence. It's about a mile and a half long, and it's made it really good for us to rotate our pastures and things, and it helps our neighbors as well.
Out here on our winter range, this part, we have spiked it to increase the feed in this area here. And with the help of my sister and her kids and our other niece and nephews helped us to get this so we can have better feed in this area of the allotment that we have.
We're on our summer range right here, one of our canyons here where we've reseeded it. You can see the reseeding that we've done. I've pushed every inch of this bottom out with my dozer, and I plowed it and planted intermediate wheatgrass, Russian wild rye, some spreader alfalfa, a little bit of brome grass, crested. And it's really, you can see up through here, it's really made a difference, and it's been really, really good for our animals and also the wildlife. It's been a good mixture for the wildlife. This is an area right here where we've been clearing. My son, Tylon, has been clearing this with our cat, been pushing this trees and things in this wash that you can see right here, trying to stop the erosion. We'll come back in here and reseed this. This is a reservoir that we put in here in this canyon of mine. It services the whole community or whole town of Alton. The property owners in Alton with their irrigation system, sprinkling system, and also the Alton Irrigation Company. This road we built in 1997, it's really been a plus for us, because before the old road used to go down through a meadow down through here, and it was full of, get a lot of water in it, and it, a lot of erosion was starting to occur down there. So we built this road up around here, and it's really been a big benefit for us.
Besides running the ranch, Mom and Dad both taught school here at Valley High School. Mom taught for 23 years in home economics, English, and was also the driver's ed teacher. Dad taught botany, math, and PE classes for 45 years, and he is also currently the athletic director. For the past 32 years, Dad has ran basketball summer camps throughout the state of Utah for kids between the ages of 5 and 18 years old. He has 14 state championships, 7 in girls basketball, 2 in volleyball, and 5 consecutive state boys golf championships.
I grew up on a ranch as well, working with cattle, and I really loved it. So when I chose a mate, I chose one that I could live this kind of life.
I think it's really important to take care of the land. I've always felt, and my dad taught me these principles as well, if you take care of the land will take care of you. So it's really, really important, I think, to pass these values on to my children and my grandkids.
I'm Joel Ferry, and this is my dad, John Ferry, and my uncle, Ben Ferry, and we run J.Y. Ferry & Son. We're located here in Corinne, Utah. We run a feed yard, a cow-calf operation, and we also raise crops, corn, wheat, alfalfa, and grass hay. We also manage thousands of acres of wetlands for waterfowl habitat, for hunting, and also for grazing.
Our family came out in the 1900s, actually 1900 itself, when the Bear River Canal System was built. And originally they bought parcels of property and developed it using a team of horses and a 4-foot scraper. Today we carry that heritage on, but our equipment that we use is significantly different. We use lasers and other types of equipment that enables us to complete the conservation that's important to us for the habitat development and also for improving and conserving water.
Well, a farm and a ranch's greatest resource is the land. If you take care of the land will take care of you. And you have to be able to, as a manager of this resource, be able to see what is the best use of the land. The land will tell you. All you have to do is listen.
Conservation work has been something that's always been important to me. Some people call me a duck farmer. It's because I love to work in the wetlands and I love to create these habitat areas that are so important that really benefit our farm and ranch. And to me, I look at the work that we've done. I have 5 young children, I have 4 boys, and I want that legacy to carry on to them. I take them out duck hunting with me, I take them irrigating with me, they drive in the tractor with me, and I want to teach them the principles that I learned from my grandpa, from my dad, from my uncle, so that they can gain an appreciation and a love for this land as well. We've done a wide variety of conservation from both our farm ground to our wetlands to our range. Some of the projects we've done have been pollution reduction. I decommissioned a feed yard that sat right on the Bear River last year because there was a potential for it to pollute the Bear River. Stream bank restoration here on the Bear River to prevent sedimentation from entering the river stream. That's another way. Every project has a certain benefit that benefits the public.
One of the biggest problems, for example, we've had on the wetlands, there's a plant called Phragmites, which will totally take over a wetlands and make it useless. We have found ways of grazing the Phragmites and using grazing as a tool to manage the wetlands for the wildlife.
Out in west, Box Elder County, we have installed roughly 5 miles of pipeline and with 20,000 gallons of different storage tanks up high so that they gravity down to various water troughs so that we can control where they graze based on where the water source is.
I hope that what we see behind us in 50 years from now looks just like it does today. That's the goal, is to maintain what we have, to protect it, and to keep it beautiful and pristine just like it is here. I want my kids, my grandkids, to be able to have the opportunity to come out and hunt on these ponds, to enjoy them, to watch birds, and to have this resource available to them forever.
We're honored to be a finalist this year for the Utah Leopold Conservation Award and show a little bit of what our operation does to conserve and be stewards to the land.
We are today here in Chalk Creek, which is 6 miles east of Colville, Utah. The Chalk Creek flows into Echo Reservoir, flows into the Weber drainage. Here today with me is my son McCoy Pace and my wife Mackenzie and my younger son McCason. And here on the ranch, this is a cow-calf operation, a full grazing outfit for 365 days a year. We feed very little hay on this operation. We go to a desert permit for 6 months, and then we also come to our ranch here in Colville and surrounding areas here in Summit County.
Ranching is really important in our family. It's what Colby grew up doing, and I learned later in life after I married him kind of the ropes of the ranching. And we are definitely a ranching family, and our 2 boys here, McCoy and McCason, they are the ones that help Colby make this operation go round. We're trying to teach them, all the ropes of being conservationists and stewards to the land. And we hope that one day our operation will be passed down to them and many generations after that.
I think ranching in our family needs to carry on through my kids and their kids and their kids, because ranching is one of the greatest things that I've ever done in my life, and it's helped me to become the man I am today.
Well, helping my dad move the cows, it's pretty fun, and you can't stand not going without him when school starts to come, and helping him around in the summer and the fall and helping in the spring quite a bit.
Some of our conservation projects that we have had here on the ranch, one is the creek restoration project. In around 1993, they came in here and did a whole bunch of vegetation work, and we did a whole bunch of rock structure work, better fish habitat for the Bonneville cutthroat. This is one of our water development programs that we have here. This is a 36-inch pipe that's 20 feet in the ground. This 8-panel solar system here puts 5 gallons a minute up at 480 feet. Cattle drink here, wildlife drink here, squirrels drink here. There's wildlife ramps that go to these troughs that make them eco-friendly for the wildlife. This is one of our pastures that's in part of our pasture rotation system. This particular ranch here that we're standing on today has 6 different pastures that we use. So this is one of the cross fences that have many that we've put in on the ranch. This one here separates a lower pasture from an upper pasture. It was just put in since we allocated the water, and the water that we put in above here, now the cattle can graze on the top side of this pasture and the lower side. Before, it could only graze on one side of the pasture. They had to graze all of it at one time. Cover crops has helped us. So we have planted cover crops in the fall of the year and been able to use them cover crops in the spring and the fall. This is a pinyon juniper removal. We took a hand crew and knocked all these trees down, and then the grasses came back up underneath here and for the watershed and for the habitat of the wildlife. In this particular drainage, in the South Fork drainage and the Chalk Creek drainage, we've introduced a CRMP, which is a Cooperative Resource Management Plan, which consisted of 17 landlords and about 34,000 acres. So not only us on this ranch has been sustainable, but many of our neighbors have been sustainable also. So what have we done to share this with other folks in our ranching industry is we've had the Utah wool growers out here to kind of demonstrate what we've had. Also, I am the Soil Conservation District Chairman. I've been to numerous different places in the country with the NCBA and with the Utah Cattlemen's to better my knowledge and to better other people's knowledge, because people are always asking of how to look at their ranch as a better sustainable ranch.
The ranching life, honestly, is the best life that you could ever ask for. It has been a great way to raise our kids. Like, I'm so grateful that I get to raise our kids amongst this. Like, this is their backyard, this is where they play, this is where they work, and I'm very, very, very grateful for our life.